Hey, and welcome to another video. So today we are going to show you guys how to add IP PoE camera to a DVR. So as you know, DVRs are traditionally use the BNC connections, as you can see here. But what we're going to do is show you how to add an IP camera through the network. So most Hikvision DVRs allow this feature, and a lot of DVRs in the market do this as well. So for example, this is an 8-channel DVR. You can see we've got 8 channels here. You can actually add 4 more IP cameras to it via a switch. Or you can just go 12 cameras via a switch and not use any of these, but you might as well just get an NVR for that. So, yeah, so what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to quickly connect up everything and then how to add it on the software via DVR. Really, you could have this set up in under 2 minutes, no problem. It's so easy nowadays. Okay, so I'll show you what we've quickly got. So this is our normal DVR. Got 8 channels. As you see, we got the 1 Ethernet port here, which is connected to our internet. Okay. And we have our switch. So this is also connected to our internet, and it's a 4-port PoE switch. And they're about £40. Very handy to have. And you can add the cameras in via here. Okay. This is our IP camera we're going to use. It's a PTZ camera and 4 megapixel. And here's our connector. So our DVR is actually 8 megapixel, so it allows you to add up to 8 megapixel IP cameras. But the other DVRs in the market were showing up to 4 megapixel, which is handy for exactly this camera. So this camera can really be added to any NVR, any DVR out there on the market right now. So it's a very handy little bit of equipment. All right, so how do we set it up? So obviously you've got our DVR connected to the internet. Router connected to the internet. So they are all on the same network, okay? So they should be able to find each other, no problems. So what we do is we just take our cable, plug in our PTZ camera, connect it to our switch. And now all we have to do is let it power up and then we log on to our DVR and we should be able to find the camera. Okay, simple as that. So just give it a few seconds. And I'll see you in a second on our DVR and we'll show you how to add it on. All right, cheers. Okay, so now we are back to our DVR and we're going to find and add the camera. Okay, so this is pretty straightforward. So as you can see, we have no normal cameras plugged in and it won't let us go to the next page because we've added no IP cameras. So it just thinks there's 8 cameras, but we're going to add one now. So we go to the camera menu here on the left, got IP camera. Okay, so this is what IP cameras that have been added. We've got nothing at the moment. So we look down here at the bottom and we can find our cameras. Okay, so it's found this one. This is our PTZ, which we just plugged in. Okay, so we click on here and we first of all need to activate it. Okay, pretty straightforward, I have to do much here. We just use the channel default password. So this will take the password from your DVR already. Okay, nice and easy. So we go okay, and now our camera is active. And then we click on the same camera again, we go add. And now it's added it. Okay, just give it a few seconds to sort itself out. Then we go back to our live view. Okay, we see at the bottom now we have 2 pages. So we go to the second page. Oh, and it's found me. Okay, so the camera, it's been found already and it's added it to our DVR. So we can change the menu here. We can go like this so we can see all the cameras in one view. Okay, but if we want to access the PTZ, yeah, we could just do it straight from the menu, even though it's IP. Okay, there we go. So this is how you configure an analog system to add an IP camera to it. Okay, I hope you guys learned something and you managed to now have a few extra cameras on your DVR. All right, cheers. Thanks and see you next time. Bye-bye.